way for us to sit high on this panel and discuss infertility. It is a big step that we have made as African and African leaders. I think we should give ourselves a hand for that. Because before, you wouldn't have such conferences sitting down talking about infertility. Like you had even before other speakers, it is a taboo. It's like you're a cursed woman when you don't have a child. Everybody looks down upon you. And to have somebody like me in a leadership platform, to even start talking about my own experience, it's very difficult. But then when you become a leader, you have a choice, either to tell your story or to let other people tell your story. So I chose that level of saying, this is the platform that the people have given me. I have to use the platform in order to create awareness so that other people before me or behind me would not go through the same problem. Part of the video that you haven't seen is I had to adopt my own child because he was born from a surrogate mother. And the law that we had in Kenya, that still is in Kenya, does not recognize surrogacy. So after my baby was born, the surrogate mother was a good friend of mine. So she agreed for me to take the baby from day one. But then legally, that baby was not mine. I mean, after everything that we produced, the agreement from the lawyers to show that the baby is mine, because that was my egg, and my ex-husband's sperm, but still they did not recognize that, because the law that was in place says the woman who gives birth is the mother of the baby. So those who have children and a surrogate process, they're not recognized by law. So I decided to take a longer journey, because surrogacy is not new in our country. Women go through the same process, or couples go through that process, but then what they do, they go through the back door to get, you know, legal certificates for their children. But then here I am, I've declared interest to become a leader. Nobody has ever seen me pregnant. Then what do I do? I said, I'll take the long journey. It doesn't matter how long it's going to be. It was in and out of courts and seeing the lawyers and the judges. It took us almost 4 years to now be able now to legally be recognized as the mother of my son. So I went through the normal adoption process. And when I got to Parliament, I said, we have to change this law, because we cannot let any couple or any woman to go through this painful journey. And when I got there, another member of Parliament who was there, previous Parliament before me, had a draft on IVF. So what we did, we put our heads together, and I championed for that bill. We called upon all the stakeholders, all the doctors, and people who are in charge of infertility and IVF clinics in Kenya. And together we came up with a very good bill. And in this bill, it recognizes you as a woman who gets a baby, either through adoption or through surrogacy process, to be identified as mother of that child. And not just that, also to regulate the IVF process that has been happening in the country, and also to create awareness to tell people that there are other methods that you can use if you cannot conceive naturally. As we've seen in the video, like lack of information, lack of knowledge is something that's really making people suffer, making women suffer. Women are the ones who carry all the embarrassment. They carry the shame. They cry tears at night. And sometimes they're not the ones who are carrying that problem. It is a shared responsibility. I want to thank Merck, because through this initiative, it has opened up conversation. It has opened up, you know, talking amongst the men. Men are coming out also to talk about their problems. And one by one, we're seeing them accompanying their spouses to the clinic, so that they know that it's not just a woman's problem, but also a man has that problem too. And we're happy because now, just 1 week ago, we passed the, we changed from IVF bill to assisted reproductive technology, so that now we can cover all the other methods that are available, not just IVF. So already we passed that bill at the National Assembly, and it is the first bill actually in Kenya. Maybe in Africa, I'm not sure about other countries. In Africa, it is the first bill in Africa. And right now it is it has been taken to Senate, and after Senate it will come back to the National Assembly so that after that the President now can sign it into law. So it is the biggest achievement that we have achieved as women parliamentarians in Kenya, and we're not going to stop there, because if we don't take it down to where the people are, lack of information will still be like a bondage around them. Because sometimes you make good laws, but then implementing those laws becomes an issue. And if they're not implemented, then we're not going to realize the culture shift that we are talking about. Because when we have more information going down to the people, then you find out they start talking about it freely, and they have access to information, access to medical treatment for early prevention, early detection, and also so that the price of it or the cost of